Assalamu alaikum students. Today's lecture is about DDL, data definition language. Data definition language is a part of SQL. As you know that SQL is the language used by RDBMS or simply DBMS, and this part of SQL is actually used for the creation and modification of database structures. Simply, we can say that it deals with the description of the database schema and used to create and modify the structure database objects in the database. So far, we have studied SQL commands. We studied DQL and also DML. Today, we will study DDL, data definition language. These are the objectives. Actually, the main objective of this lecture is to let you know that how can we create or modify different objects in the database, or simply you can say that how can we define database schema. These are the contents. First, we will study about DDL. Then we have different type of queries available under DDL, and we will study all these queries one by one, and also we will do practice some examples in the workbench. Data definition language is used to create and modify the structure of database objects in the database. Actually, this language or the part of SQL is used to create different objects in a database. Even the database itself is created with the help of DDL command. So whenever we start our database development, we need DDL commands for creation of objects like tables, views, procedures, etc. And once these objects are created, we also need some modification commands, and those commands are under DDL. So inside DDL, we have create queries. Create queries are used to create objects or databases, and we can also use drop keywords. Drop is used to delete objects from the database. Alter is used to alter the structure of the database. Truncate can be used to remove all the record from the database table. Not the table, only the record in a table can be deleted with the help of truncate. Then we have comment. It is just like we use comments in other programming languages. And at the end, we have rename. Rename is used to rename an object existing in the database. First, SQL create. With the help of SQL create, we can create different type of objects. We have some examples here. We can create database, we can create table, we can create views, and also there are some other things that could also be created with the help of this create keyword. In this lecture, we will practice only this create database and create table. Create view will be practiced in another lecture. So this is the syntax for creating a database. First, we need to type create, then keyword database, and after that the name of the database. For example, I am going to create a database named as student, so I must type create database student. I need to create a database let's say for employees, so I must type create database employees. We can also use schema instead of database. This is the synonym for database. Both are same. Both will create databases for us. There's nothing different. And also we can use if not exists clause. If a database has been created, so next time if we execute the same statement, that will give us error. So to avoid that type of error, we can use this if not exists. So now we are going to create a database in our MySQL workbench. So here we are going to create a new database in the MySQL workbench. We have already created some databases present under schema. Now I'm going to type a create query to create a new database. So here I must type create database, imply and control enter. Create database imply, one row affected, and this database has been created. Now you can refresh it. We got this imply here. I can also create a database like this. If I type create schema imply 2 and control enter, this database has been created. Now refresh it and check it here. Imply 2 is now present here. So with the help of create query, we can create databases. You can easily type create database or create schema, both are same. Now if I execute this statement again, I will get error. Select it and control enter. We got error here. So to avoid such type of error, we can type if not exists, and now execute it. We got warning instead of error. So we can also use this if not exist clause for this query. In the create database query, we can also specify some additional specifications like the character set, identification, the collision, and the default encryption. So for that purpose, we must type the same query as we did create database or schema, and we can also type if not exist then database name, and after that we must specify the character set. You can type default if you are using default character set, and if you are specifying a character set, so for that purpose you must type character set equals the name of character set, and then collate for collision equals to the collision name, and also default encryption yes or no. Now suppose we need a database having character set equal to ASCII and collision equal to ASCII bin. We have already studied about this character set and collision in our previous lectures that was related to architecture of the database. So now for that purpose I must type create schema. Let's say the database which we need is ABCD E, and after that we must type default character set ASCII and collate ASCII bin. So execute it. This query has been executed and you can get this database here. ABCD is now present in the list. For creating tables in a database, we must type create then table. These two are keywords. After that the name of the table, the new table which will be created, and inside the table the list of columns will be inside two parentheses. So with each column we must specify its data type and size, and we can also specify some additional parameters like not null and primary key. So we can also specify the primary key at the end of all these columns. Note one thing, that all these columns must be separated by commas. Suppose I'm going to create a table for employee info, so I must type create table employee info, and after that parenthesis start employee id. Its type is, let's say, number. So for that purpose, I must type int. No need to specify size with int. And if we are using varchar, then we must specify the size. And after that, we must type name for imply varchar. Let's say size is 30. And after that, we can also specify third column, let's say address varchar size 50, and then close the parenthesis. So after executing this query, we will get a table named as imply, and it would have three columns, but there will be no primary key in the table. So if we need to specify a primary key, then we must type primary key at the end. We have a database named as imply. We are going to create a table inside this imply. Currently there is no table inside the imply as we created this database now, and it's empty. So we will create a new table named as imply info inside this imply. So for that purpose, I must select this imply first. You can select it here by clicking this set as default schema, or you can type use and this database name. This imply got selected now, and now I need to create a table. So for that purpose, I must type create table, then the name of the table, so it would be imply info. That I must give the list of the attributes inside this imply info. So I am giving imply ID and its data type varchar. Let's say the size is 12, and then the imply name varchar size is, let's say, 30. So this query will create a new table for us named as imply info, and it will have two attributes, imply ID and imply name. Spelling of this one is not correct. Now select it and execute it, control enter. This query has been executed. You can check it here, refresh it. Now we can get this table here under imply. Its name is imply info, and it has two columns, imply ID and imply name. You can check the metadata of these two columns here. Its type is varchar 30, its name is imply name. There is no primary key in this table. Now if we need a primary key in the table, then we must specify the primary key in create table query. So for that purpose, we must type here one another query, and here I am giving the name of table as imply info 2, and here primary key, and it should be emp underscore id. Now with the help of this query, we will create another table named as imply info. It will have two attributes, imply id and imply name, and the imply id would be primary key. So execute it, control enter. This got executed. Now refresh it. Here we have one another table named as imply info. It has two columns, imply ID and imply name. This one is now primary key for the table. You can check it here in the metadata section. Here you will find PK, and in the previous case there was no PK with either attribute. While using the create table query, we can also add, or we can also supply some additional parameters for columns, like here for column 1 we have not null and primary key. So with the help of these keywords we will supply some additional restrictions or characteristics to this new attributes. So not null will not allow us to give any null value, or simply you can say that while using this database we must provide some value to column 1, and with the help of this primary key the column 1 will be considered as primary key of this table. Similarly, we can also allow a column to get any null value, or we can say that during input we would be allowed to not provide any value to column 2. We can also specify default value for an attribute. So for that purpose we must type default keyword and then the default value. So if we are not giving any value to a column, in that case the default value will be considered. Now we are giving some additional parameters with these attributes. So I am going to create a third table. Let's say we have a table named as employee info 3, and here I'm deleting this primary key and specifying this employee ID as primary key by typing primary key here. And also I need this attribute to be not null. Employee name can be null, so I must type it like this. And let's say we have another attribute, imply address. Its type is, let's say, watcher, and its default value would be, let's say, unknown. So with the help of this query we will create a table named as employee info 3. It will have employee ID, its type would be varchar, size would be 12, it would be primary key, and it would be not null. So we will not be able to keep this employee ID as null, but for employee name we can keep it as null by not providing any value, and its type would be also varchar with 30 size. And we will have a third column named as employee address having varchar 50, and the default value for address would be unknown. Means if we don't supply any value to employee address, then it will get the value as unknown. Execute it, control enter, this query got executed. Now we can check it here, refresh it, and we will have employee info 3. It has three attributes, employee ID, this one is PK, primary key, employee name is watcher 30, and employee address watcher 50. So this employee info 3 got created, and we provided some additional parameters with each attribute. We can also create a table from an existing table. So for that purpose we will use the same create table query, but here we will not specify the new columns as we are creating a table from the existing table. So for that purpose we must use a select query inside the create table attached with as keyword. So Actually, this select statement will give us a result, and according to this result, we will create a new table. Now we are going to create a new table from an existing table. We have another database named as student here. It has some tables, so we will create a table from this basic info. It has, let's say, it has three attributes: registration number, name, and if name. We will create a new table having registration and name only. We will omit this if name. So first let's check what we have in these attributes. After that we will create a table for this. So I'm checking this table. So select *, from the database name is student dot table name is basic info. Control enter. We got the list of values stored in this basic info table in the student database. Now I need to create a new table from this existing table. We can also apply a where clause here, where, let's say, name like starting with A and execute it. So we have these values starting with A. So we will create a new table for these O values. Now what we need? We need create table query, and here I'm giving a name as sample, and after that I must type as, and then I must type this select query. So with the help of this query, we will create a new table from an existing table, which is basic info stored in the student database, and we will also apply a where clause to get only the names starting with A. We will get actually these values in the new table. So execute it, control enter. This query got executed. We can check it here in our employee database. Right click on it, refresh. We will have a new table here. Yes, sample. This is the new table, and it has three attributes: registration name and F name, and these will have the values according to this where clause. We can also specify these attributes by typing their name here. Let's say I need reg and name only, so I must type here sample 2. So this query will give us a new table named as sample 2, and it will be created from basic info. But in basic info there are three attributes, and in this table we will have two attributes. Executed. This got executed. Now check this new table here. Sample 2 is present. It has two columns. We can check the contents of this table. Select *, from sample 2. Control enter. We got these values. So that in the actual table there was another column that was named as fname. It's not present because we have provided only two attributes in our create query.